Hailing from South Bend, Indiana, Blake Wesley is a 6'4" guard weighing 187 pounds with a 6'9" wingspan who played his college ball at Notre Dame. Let's start with the offensive end. He's a pretty good finisher at the rim for a guard. He's got a nice finishing package and can make a variety of shots. Here he beats Caleb Love off the dribble and gets to the rim, where he goes up and under for the righty reverse layup. In this one, he's in a pick and roll and takes his man on, but his path gets blocked. So he decides to get up and finger roll this in over him. This is a similar one, except he kind of bounces off his man and hits this fadeaway shot. He's also quite quick and manages to make these finishes and stay in control at high speeds. Here he cuts to the basket and gets the pass in the paint before bringing out a nice little hop step and finish at the hoop. In this one, he shows good patience and baits Theo John into coming out, which allows him to slither through to an opening in the paint, and that's an easy finish. Here's some more of that patience. He's back in the pick and roll and he waits for Coburn to jump for the contest before going up. He's a solid ball handler too. He's got a few dribble moves that he likes to go to, most notably this crossover. I think he could be solid enough to run some offense through him at the next level, but I don't think he's quite polished enough to be a primary offensive linchpin at this point in time. He's got a little mid-range game as well. Here he gets the switch on the bigger guy and penetrates into the paint before spinning and then hitting the step back from the elbow. In fact, he loves using these spins to set up his mid-range J's. In this one, he has the ball late in the second half with the game on the line and penetrates into the paint before pulling up all over the ACC logo and drawing this big bucket. This is a weapon he uses in the pick and roll as well. He'll also pull up like this in transition as well, if defenses overcommit to protecting the paint. When it comes to his shooting, I'd say he's a below average shooter at this point in time. His poor free throw percentage doesn't provide much optimism either. He shoots a fair amount of them, and his efficiency isn't awful, so that's encouraging. He has shown, however, that when they do go in, they can come from a variety of situations. He can hit them off the catch, or when pulling up. At everything is possible, he could get to an average level as a shooter. He's a confident shooter with a decent looking shot and shoots well from the mid-range. I wouldn't bank on it coming around, but it's a possibility. He's an alright passer. He didn't really ever make any particularly high level reads, barring maybe a few instances. He can create on the move though. He makes these kick-out passes to shooters too. He'll also create out of pick and roll scenarios. He often gets into passing lanes like this. He's very active as an on-ball defender, but he's sometimes too keen and overcommits instead of picking his moments. His screen navigation was either great or terrible. Here he goes under Baycott's screen instead of over. He scored nearly 30 points as a large contributor for Notre Dame. His 49.5% true shooting percentage is not great at all. And a lot of that is because of his 30% on 10 threes and 67% on his free throws. That is concerning, but the volume is slightly reassuring. His 5 assists and 17.4% assist rate is pretty good and nice to see, although the turnovers are a bit high. His steal plus block numbers are reasonable, but that's almost all down to his 2.6 steals. The hype around Wesley has been up and down all year, and a lot of that was because that's how his play went. His scoring has to translate for him to stick in the league. If the jumper comes along as well, I could see him carving out a nice little role for himself. That seems like the only real route to him being successful though. I don't think there's high level playmaking or defensive potential there. A realistic floor for him would be a small role scorer off the bench. A realistic ceiling for him would be a low level starter slash lead scorer of a second unit for a good team.